Good morning, children. Okay. In the last class, we discussed about matrices, isn't it? What is a matrix? What is a matrix? Yes, Anila, Mohanan. Matrix is the
rectangular arrangement of elements in rows and columns.
Very good. It is a rectangular. You mentioned that word. That wording is important. Okay. It is a rectangular arrangement. It is not simply an arrangement. It is arranged in rectangular form. That wording is to be included. So it is a rectangular arrangement of elements in rows and columns. Okay. A matrix of order 2 by 3 will have 6 elements. And we discussed about few operations, isn't it? Which are the types of operations we discussed, Karthik?
Yes, ma'am.
What are the different types of operations we discussed in matrices?
Equality of matrices,
isn't it? Two matrices are said to be equal if the order is same and the corresponding entries are also same. Then,
the addition next, of matrices.
Addition. Okay, what is the condition we have learned about addition, Aparna? In which case we will be able to add two matrices? Addition of matrices. Tell me, in which situation we will be able to add or subtract?
Ma'am, is the order of the two.
Order must be same, isn't it? Order of both them. If order of A and order of B is same, then we can add A and B. And A plus B will be also of same order. Order will not change. Okay, then we have learned about what is the next type? Addition. Then tell me, Karthik, what is the next one?
Negative of matrix.
Negative of a matrix means we multiply the entries, each and every entry of matrix, by a negative sign, isn't it? We multiply by 1 minus 1. Then next one.
Multiplication of matrix.
Multiplication we didn't learn, okay? Is it multiplication? Check it, Karthik. Is it multiplication? Or one word is there in front of it. What is that?
By a scalar.
Multiplication of a matrix by scalar. We are multiplying by a number. Okay. The next one we will be learning. In the next period, we will be learning multiplication of matrices. Okay. That is different. We will multiply two matrices and all. Here, we learned how to multiply a matrix by a scalar. Okay. Now, let us discuss some problems based on addition, subtraction, and scalar multiplication. Write the question, children. Write the question. If matrix, write the question, children. If matrix 9 minus 1 4 minus 2 1 3 is equal to A plus 1 2 minus 1 0 4 9, find the matrix A. So look at here, what is given here? Matrix 9 1 4 minus 2 1 3 is equal to A plus another matrix. We want to find the matrix A. So how will you try this? How you will be solving this one? Yes, I'll solve this. Okay, we start from this part. Okay, we start with, it is given matrix 9, negative 1, 4, minus 2, 1, 3 is equal to A plus matrix 1, 2, minus 1, 0, 4, 9. Therefore, it will be matrix A. If we take this matrix to other side, we'll get 9, minus 1, 4, minus 2, 1, 3, minus matrix 1, 2, minus 1, 0, 4, 9 will be equal to A, isn't it? Therefore, what is the matrix A? What is matrix A? What will be matrix A? Yes. What will be the matrix A? So here we can subtract, doesn't it? We can add or we can subtract the corresponding entries. When we subtract the corresponding entries, what is the answer? What is the matrix you will get? Yes, I think Aishwarya is ready with the answer.
8 minus 3, 5.
Is it correct? Tomlin, here negative sign is there, isn't it? Negative of negative, it will become positive. Now, second row, Aditya Satyan, can you try the answer for, okay, give the second row elements.
Minus 2.
Yes, 1 minus 4. What is 1 minus 4?
Minus 3.
Okay, then? Minus 6. It is -6. Okay? Okay, children? Now, write the next one. Next one is, in the next model we are going to learn is a very important question. Next one is also a very important question. Find matrix capital X and capital Y. Find matrix capital X and capital Y such if matrix X plus Y is equal to 5 2 0 9 and X minus Y is equal to matrix 3 6 0 minus 1. Find matrix capital X and capital Y if X plus Y is equal to matrix 5 2 0 9 and X minus Y is equal to 3 6 0 1. Yes, tell me children, what is the answer? How to do this? Listen children, so here we don't know what is X, what is Y. Only thing we can fix is the order of the matrix X and Y. What is the order of the matrix X and Y? What will be the order of the matrix X and Y? Can you give the answer from the given question? Go through the question and tell me what is the order of the matrix X and Y.
2 by 2.
Very good. It is 2 by 2. Why, Aishwarya? Why is this 2 by 2?
Because there are 4 elements.
It's the order 2 rows and 2 columns. Okay, look at the answer, results there. X plus Y. We are adding 2 matrices and we are getting a 2 by 2 matrix. Is it no? We are adding X and Y. We are adding 2 matrices and X and Y and we are getting another 2 by 2 matrix. That means X and Y will be of the same order 2 by 2. We will be able to add say matrices if the order is same. And result is a 2 by 2 matrix means we are adding 2 by 2 matrix. So X and Y, the order of X and Y will be 2 by 2. Now we have learnt solving simultaneous linear equations. Elimination method, substitution method and all we have learnt. So here also we can use elimination method for finding the matrices. You can treat this capital X and capital Y as elements itself, as single numbers. Okay, how we solve linear equations? In that way itself we can solve. Instead of treating it as a matrix, we can keep it as a variable and you can solve. Look at here how I am going to solve this. Listen children, I name the equations 1 and 2. Suppose I add the equations 1 plus 2. What happens? Tell me, Karthik. Tell me. When we add this 1 plus 2, what you will get?
2x.
2x plus y minus y will get cancelled. So we get 2x is equal to. Here also we can add 5, 2, 0, 9 plus matrix 3, 6, 0, minus 1. When we add this, what is the answer? What is 2x? 8, 8, 0, 8. Therefore, what is x? Into 2, on going other side, it will become half of, isn't it? It is division. 8 8 0 8. So what is the matrix X? What will be matrix X, Tomlin? What is matrix X? Half of 8 8. 4 4 0 4. So we got the matrix X. Now substitute X in any one of the equations and you can find Y. Substitute X in any one of the equation. We can substitute this in first equation. I am substituting this in first equation. So in first equation we have X plus Y is equal to matrix 5 2 0 9. From here find out, calculate Y and give me what is the value of Y. Is the method okay, Femina? Femina,
yes,
matrix is an easy chapter. You can score marks easily in this chapter. Okay, children. This Saturday we are not having the period. Monday, get ready for a test paper in linear inequalities. Monday, get ready for a test paper in linear inequalities. Okay. Keep the graph paper. One graph question will be asked, one word problem will be asked, and one simple question will be asked out of 5 marks test paper. Get ready for the test paper. Finished. What is the value of Y, Anila?
1 minus 2 0.
Y is
1 minus 2.
1 minus 2 1 minus 2 0 5 0 5. What about the others? Is it correct, children? Are you getting this answer, Jomlin?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Write the next one. Write the next one. Find the value of X plus Y. Find the value of X plus Y. Find the value of X plus Y. If if 2 into matrix 1 3 0 x plus matrix y 0 1 2 is equal to 2 into matrix 1 3 0 x plus matrix Y0, 1, 2 is equal to matrix 5, 6, 1, 8. 5, 6, 1, 8. If these two matrices are equal, we want to find what is X plus Y. We have to find what is X plus Y. Yes, Femina, give me the steps, Femina. How will you solve this one? We can do it together. Tell me. We want to find what is X plus Y. How will you do this? Yes? How to do this? Femina, give the steps, Femina. Femina, Tomlin, turn on your video. Femina, give me the steps, how you will be doing this one. Femina, can you hear me? Yes, Femina, are you there? Femina, okay, Tomlin, give the steps, Tomlin. First we multiply, scalar multiplication, isn't it? We multiply the matrix by scalar. So when you multiply, what you will get? See whether you, okay, 2x plus then y 0,
one,
yes, 5, 6, 1, 8. So what is the next step?
2 plus y.
2 plus y. Then?
6.
6. 1. 2x plus 2. Equal to matrix 5, 6, 1, 8. So if two matrices are equal, corresponding entries are equal, isn't it? Equate this and give what is x, what is y. Aditya, Satyan, find out and tell me the value of x and y. Yes. X is y. What is x? What is y? And what is x plus y? What is the value of x? Anila, please give the answer. I think they are all having the network issues. If they say something also, I am not able to hear. What is the value of
y is 3.
Y is 3, okay. X is 3. Is it 3? Yes. So what is the value of x plus y? Is it 6?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay, children. So the addition of matrices, is it clear, children? Is it clear for you how to add two matrices? Is it okay? Is it okay, children? Now, the next one we are going to learn is, okay, now till now we have learned in which case we will be able to add two matrices and in which situation will be subtract matrices and all. Now we are going to learn multiplication of two matrices. Write the heading. Multiplication of two matrices. Multiplication of two matrices. multiplication of two matrices. Sorry. Multiplication of matrices. Now listen, children, suppose you are given with two matrices A and B. You are given with two matrices A and B. So we can multiply A with B. Listen, we can multiply A with B if number of columns of A is equal to number of rows in B. Look at here, we can multiply A matrix A with matrix B if number of columns in A, first matrix A, will be equal to number of rows in the second matrix B. Is it clear? Listen, we can multiply two matrices. Okay, we can define AB. We can define AB only if the product AB can be defined only if the important point is number of columns in A is equal to number of rows in B. Okay, if this thing happens, that is, if the number of columns in A is equal to number of rows in B, then we can say A is confirmable for B for multiplication. We can confirmably multiply. A is confirmable to B for multiplication. It is confirmable. Or in sometimes in your questions and all, it may be asked compactable. It is compactable. Okay. It is compactable. Okay, just check the compactibility. Sometimes they ask, check the compactibility, or is it possible to multiply? Means this is the case, you have to check. Confirmable. For B. Okay, now listen, children. In which case you can define BA? Suppose I want to multiply BA. In which case we can define BA? In which situation you will define BA? Yes, try this, children. Tell me. Suppose yes. I want to define BA. Then we can define BA only if
number of columns in B.
Number of columns in B. Yes.
Is equal to number of rows in A.
Is equal to number of rows in A. Is equal to number of rows in A. Then only you can define BA. Okay. For example, look at children, listen. Suppose A is a matrix of order 2 by 3 and B is a matrix of order 3 by 1. Now, is it AB? Is it possible to define AB? Is it possible to define AB? Look at here. Number of columns is equal to number of rows, isn't it? So, we can define AB. Listen, children, one more point I am going to define it now. So, we can define AB. And what is the order of AB? It's a one mark question. Order of AB is, look at here, which is non common here? 2 by 1. Here this is 2, this is 1. AB will be a matrix of order 2 by 1. Okay? Let's go through another example. Okay? After this, we can learn the definition. Okay? You can write the notes. First, let's go through some examples. Let's make it clear and then we can write the notes. Look at here. Suppose A is a matrix of order 3 by 1 and B is a matrix of order 1 by 2. Is it possible to define AB? Is it possible to define AB? Look at the order. Is it same? Can we define AB? number of columns of the first matrix must be equal to number of rows. So we can define AB. What is the order of AB? What is the order of AB? Yes, Karthik, what is the order of AB? Which is left out here? That is the order. Yes.
3/2.
3/2. It is 3/2. Okay, write down this, children. Copy this. Now, for the same examples, let us check with BA. Okay, for the same examples, we are going to check whether BA is possible or not. Okay, now look at here. Now listen. Okay, I am going to define BA. Suppose B is a matrix. Okay, the, for the same example, for the same example. Okay, look at the order of B. Order of B is 3/1. What is the order of A? 2/3. Is it possible to define AB? Is it, sorry, not AB, BA?
No.
No, isn't it? So, here, we can't define BA, we can't define BA. So, BA cannot be defined. What is the reason? What is the reason? Number of columns in B is not equal to number of rows in A. Okay, number of columns in B is not equal to number of rows in A. What about the second example? Look in the second example. Second example, is it possible? B is a matrix of order 1/2. A is a matrix of order 3/1. Now, in this case, is it possible? It is also, here also it is not possible, isn't it? No. So, it is not possible to define AB. It is matrix, sorry, not AB. Okay, not possible to find BA. Here, although we are able to find AB, we are not able to define BA. Okay. You copied up to this, children. Shall we write the next point? Shall we move on to the next point? Okay, children, is it okay? Checking the compactability of matrix multiplication, is it clear? We'll be able to multiply two matrices if number of columns of the first matrix is equal to number of rows of second matrix. Now listen to my question. Is it possible to multiply two matrices, square matrices of the same order? Of the same order. Imagine A is a square matrix of order 2. B is a square matrix of order 2. Is it possible to define AB? What is meant by square matrix?
Yes.
Yes, Aditya is saying yes. Good. What about the others? Is it possible to define AB?
The rows and columns will be same, then we can define it right.
Very good. Yes, it's a 2/2 matrix. A is a 2/2 matrix, B is a 2/2 matrix. Is it possible to define AB and BA? Yes, isn't it? It's a 2/2 matrix. So, number of rows and number of columns in the first matrix and second matrix are same. So, write this as note. Note, children, write this as note. You can write this. Okay, these are all important points. Listen, children. If capital A is a matrix, so suppose capital A is a m by n matrix. Suppose capital A is a m by n matrix, is an m by n matrix, and B is an n by p matrix. If A is an m by n matrix and B is an n by p matrix, then matrix AB can be defined. Then matrix AB can be defined. Why? Why we can define AB? Within bracket you write, number of columns of A is equal to number of rows of B. So that is why we are able to define AB. Okay, yeah, that's why we are able to define AB. Number of columns of A is equal to number of rows of B. So the matrix AB can be defined, and what is the order of AB? Order of AB is, what will be the order? A is an m by n matrix, B is an n by p matrix. So what will be the order of AB?
M by p.
It is an m by p matrix. It is an m by p matrix. Okay, these are all important 1 mark question. Second one. Okay, in the previous example and all we have learnt, so in some problems we are able to define AB, in some cases we are not able to define AB. So what we can say, matrix multiplication is not commutative. Matrix multiplication is not commutative. That means AB need not be equal to BA. Is non-commutative. That means it is AB is not equal to BA. AB is not equal to BA. Okay, now we are going to learn how to multiply two matrices. The next thing we are going to learn is how to multiply two matrices. Write the question. If A is equal to matrix 2 minus 1, 3, 4, 1, 5, and B is equal to matrix minus 1, 3, 2, 1, minus 1, 3, 2, 1, find AB. Does BA exist? Find AB, then we have to check whether BA exists or not. Find AB, does BA exist or not? Okay, now look at here. Before doing the multiplication, you can check. Look at the order of AB. What is the order of AB here? Karthik?
Ma'am, 3 by 2.
3 by 2. And what is the order of B matrix?
2 by 2.
2 by 2. So when we find AB, what will be the order of AB?
3 by 2.
You'll be getting a 3 by 2 matrix. Now listen, children, sit straight. Keep your pen down. Sit straight. Don't write. Listen to me. So I'm going to define AB. So I'm writing the matrix A. 2 minus 1, 3, 4, 1, 5 into B. minus 1, 3, 2, 1. Listen, children, listen. Don't write. Listen. I'm going to find the product. How we are going to do? Listen. Row with column. Okay. What do you have to do? Take the first row, multiply with the corresponding elements of column. Row with column. Look at here. 2 into minus 1. How am I multiplying here? First row with first here. Plus, now take the second element of the first row with the second element of the column. Minus 1 into 2. With the first row, first column. I am filling the first row, first column. Now, with the first row, one more column is there. With the first row, now give it for the next column. With the first row, I am giving it for the next column. Okay, when you take it for the next column, 2 into 3 plus minus 1 into 1. First row, first we are multiplying with first column, that is the first row entry. First row with the second column, when we multiply, first element should be multiplied with the first one, second element to be multiplied with second one. Now is there any other column? No, we can stop. So take the first row, multiply with all the columns of the second matrix. Is it okay? Now with first row we have completed. Now take the second row. What is the second row here? 3 and 4. Second row elements are 3 and 4. With the second row, again you do give it for the first column. Row with column. You take row and here with column. So what you will get? 3 into minus 1 plus 4 into 2. Second row, first column. Same way, second row with next column. If you take the next column, 3 into 3 plus 4 into 1. Now, no other column is there, we can stop. So, first row, first column, we are writing here. First row, second column, we are writing here. Now, when we take the second row, listen children, when we take the second row, we write the entries in the second row. We write the entries in the second row. Now take the third row. When we take the third row, we will be writing, we will multiply and we will be writing the answers in the third row. Now this is the third row. When you multiply this, how you will multiply? 1 into minus 1 plus 5 into 2. What about the next one? Can you give the next one? Yes. Let me check who is giving the next one. Next entry. Yes, try this. Yes.
1 into 3.
1 into 3.
Plus 5 into 1.
Plus 5 into 1. Yes, it is correct, Aishwarya. Is it clear, children? We take this third row, we multiply the first column and we write here. The third row, second column. So, when we use the third row, all the entries we will write in the third row. First row, when we multiply with first row, we will be writing in the first row. When we multiply with the second row and the columns, we write in the second row. Here third row, so we are writing in the third. Now we can simplify this and write. 2 into minus 1, so minus 2 plus minus 2. Here again, 6 plus minus 1, minus 3 plus 8, 9 plus 4, minus 1 plus 10, 3 plus 5. So, what is the answer? It is minus 4, 5, 5, 13, 9, 8. Are you getting a 3 by 2 matrix? Are you getting a 3 by 2 matrix? Tomlin, is it clear, children? Is it okay? Huh? Tomlin, my dear, tell me, children, because this is an important one. If you learn this only, we will be able to proceed further. Aditya? Do you get the idea? We'll be doing more questions. But before that, is the concept at least something did you get? Aparna, yes, how to multiply is the concept okay? Row with column. Take the first row with the column. First row, second column. We complete all the columns. Then only we will move on to the next row. Tomlin, what about Tomlin?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, the question is not over. What is asked the next part? One more part is asked there. Does BA exist? You check it whether BA will exist or not. the BA will exist. What is the order of B? What is the order of B? Order of B is 2 by 2, isn't it? What is the order of A? Order of A is 3 by 2. Now look at here, is it same? No, isn't it? Therefore, BA does not exist. We will not be able to define BA. So, BA does not exist. Okay, complete this, and we can do one more question. Do this one, do it by yourself. Okay, don't look at the board and copy it, do it. Try it and check, are you able to proceed? So, I'll mark the attendance. Okay, finished? Is it over, Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am.
Now I'll give one question before. Okay, try to do this one. Okay, and we will be discussing the same question in the next period. Okay, you try this if you are getting time. Okay, if you have time in between, try this. A is equal to matrix 1 minus 2 3 minus 4 2 5. And B is equal to matrix 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 2, 1. Find AB and BA if they exist. Find AB and BA if they exist. Okay, so you have to check for the compatibility, and you have to check. If it is there, means we can multiply, we can find the product. Try to solve this. Okay, you try this. Okay, don't need to do it. I'm not compelling you. Try it. Okay, by trying only you can understand wherever we are doing the mistakes, and all we'll be able to understand. If you are getting time, you spend 5 minutes for this. Okay, we'll be doing this again in the next period. Hope you copied that question. Okay, I end the session now, children. Meet you in the next period. Thank you.